He's a cutie.
Okay, so Fox is here and she's going to be helping me set up my first section of my wind barrier in my garden, just to give you an idea what it's like. So I've picked this line here. It's running down there from the top to the bottom. And I've selected a few different plant options. I've selected three tall tree options, one being an ava and two being pecan nuts. And I'm really hoping my little doggy doesn't run away with my signs and allows me to keep track of everything, because she has a habit of trying to run away with everything. Like now she's trying to run away with my nuts. It'll go. And I've got some smaller trees that I'm planting. So this is a coffee tree, don't worry, she looks sad, but she's good. She's actually what I call my mother coffee tree. She does might not look it, but she's at least 10 years old. But she's the mother of coffee tree to most of my others. I've tried to propagate off of her, but now she's finally going to go into the ground and do her thing. She's produced me many berries over the year. So, and then I'm going to be planting some apple seeds over there and a little further down. I know what you're saying about apples. Planting from seeds, you're not going to get edible fruit. But the thing is, I'm not planting for edible fruit. I'm planting so I can do one of my favorite hobbies, and that's make cider and vinegars. And then I've chosen this indigenous bush called the ginger bush. And the bees absolutely, absolutely love this plant, and it smells amazing. And I'm just going to plant it by putting little cuttings of it all along the row, all along here, so I can take over and make a nice fence, sort of fence line. So we've got the big trees, the smaller fruiting trees, the bush, and then we're going to put some ground cover in. So I have nasturtium, a very popular ground cover, as well as a sprig of sour fig. So sour fig is indigenous here, and it grows all along our shoreline. So if you ever come visit our local beaches here in South Africa, especially in KwaZulu-Natal, you can see loads and loads of the sour fig growing here. And a little tip, that if you're ever stung by jellyfish, you don't have to pee on yourself, just grab some of this and apply it. It's really, really good for jellyfish stings, and it's really great that it just happens to naturally grow along the coastline. It acts very similar to how aloe will and the luries and that absolutely love this. So I'm going to be planting some ground cover in between all of these. So yes, there's grass here now, but between that grass will be gone. I'll gradually get rid of it, let the ground covers take over, and let the trees take over. So, you know, let's get started. One last overall image of how it looks before I start to plant. I'm going to be using some fermented fertilizer. I fermented using goat manure from our wonderful Circe as I plant everything in, to give everything a really good boost. I was just starting to head towards spring, we're coming out of winter, and as soon as the rainy season hits, all of this should take off and look amazing. So let's get started. Well, good morning. So walking out to my yard. So yesterday I started my project of creating my first wind defense section of my lower garden. I don't know if you remember, so I decided to start digging it up and record myself laying out everything, and I was hoping to do a lovely time lapse of me digging up and planting all my plants for you. But I hadn't realized that my phone, which I had propped up against a flower pot to do the video for the time lapse, when I put it down, I accidentally pushed it to change to front facing camera instead of back facing camera, but I have about an hour's long footage of a flower pot and a bit of hose pipe. I figured you guys would be too interested in looking at a flower pot for an hour. So just know that I did plant my plants yesterday. I just started the barrier line, and this is what it looks like. Let me just hang on, give me a moment. There you go. So it doesn't look like much now, but as it grows, it's going to create a beautiful natural fence and barrier there. So you can see the ginger bush, it's looking amazing. Well, ava looks a little sad, but it'll pick up now that it's in the ground. And the nasturtium is going to take off beautifully. It's going to create a whole nice new barrier over here. So this is the first step. The next step will be planting that ball over there, which will be citrus and creepers, and that's love for another day. But this, when this grows up, this ginger bush with these beautiful flowers, let me show you. The bees love it, and it grows to about 2 meters high. So it's going to create a really nice natural barrier. And then obviously the small fruiting trees, like the coffee tree and the apples in between, and then the larger trees to create the whole forest effect when the pecan nuts and the ava take off. There's my sad looking coffee tree, but she's going to pick up fairly soon. And there you have it. So that's phase one of the front garden. And watch the video soon coming for phase two. So yeah, that's quite exciting. So like I said, phase two is going to be planting some citrus and some creepers against the other fence line. And I have another section where to create that final border to prevent the wind from coming through. I know I'm going to plant lavenders and rosemary, which are super bee friendly and bees love them. And I've been trying to consider I need like one or two small fruiting trees, and I'll plant something different. So I thought maybe the chocolate pudding fruits, if I can find some of those, that looks quite amazing, or something unusual like that. I do have a custard apple, but I'm not sure if I want to plant that one in the ground just yet, but possibly that one. But some more small fruiting trees just to create that barrier and a bit of hedging. And once that is done, we're going to start creating some beds here, killing off the grass, and making some beautiful under canopy, undercover, windsafe places to grow some food for my family. So keep following me, and I hope you enjoy watching these videos.